Hello, sunny world, and especially sunny Plymouth and sunny Jerusalem. I got an email from someone at God TV. I have my friends, and thank you very much for your email, whoever it was who sent it to me via my website. And here is my website address if you wish to send me and contact me. There's a contact form on there, and you can do it anonymously by entering a false email address and name and stuff, of course. And you can send me a message one way or another. If you want to speak to me or whatsoever, or you'd like to be in contact, absolutely in confidence, no names, no pack drill, of course, then you can enter your real email address or whatever, and I'll get back to you, no problem. However, someone kindly sent me a message the other day saying something interesting. This is totally out of the blue, and there's been no announcements of this. Wendy Alec has gone. Now, whether this is exactly true or not, I haven't yet seen any confirmatory reports yet, but nevertheless, Wendy Alec has fled, according to my source in on God TV staff, wherever in the world they are on God TV staff. And she has fled, no doubt. There has been sort of battles behind the scenes, and like all good children of the devil, of course, they like to keep things hidden. It's all about keeping up appearances and saving face and assorted other sick and wicked nonsense. We don't do that amongst God's people, but they're not God's people, they're church people. They're Antichrist, not God's people at all, but nevertheless. So I understand that Wendy Alec has fled God TV with a golden handshake of millions of pounds, UK currency, of course. But I'd be interested to hear whether how much of this is exactly true. My informant may be telling precisely the truth, and they may have got one, two things slightly wrong, making a genuine mistake, of course, and God knows we all make those. But nevertheless, if any of you happen to know what the numbers are, I'd be appreciated be very appreciative to hear that. We will let the world know what God TV's really like behind the scenes. One of the things I hate is obfuscation. People concealing things from the body of Christ, like the world. Like, you know, you've got those in senior management that really know what's going on, but lesser mortals in the company are not told. It's wicked. You don't have that in the body of Christ. In the body of Christ, everybody knows what's going on because the Lord shows them. They're all his children. No one's excluded. Every one of the genuinely born again are his people, but broad roaders that were not born again, of genuine initial illumination but not born again, and nominal Christians, they're something else entirely. But everyone who's in covenant with him, the Lord doesn't conceal anything from his covenant people. And of course, God TV is nothing to do with God. But there you go, you probably heard it here first. I did see on Wendy Alec's Twitter feed that she talks about there being big things going on behind the scenes. Yeah, you bet. Boardroom battles, all the usual stuff. Nevertheless, and that it sounds like she's gone with a rather large amount of donors' money in her pocket. You've been through a bloody divorce with her husband, Rory, and of course their surname isn't Alec at all, it's Stevenson or Stevens, I can't remember exactly. And I sincerely hope that the daughter of the family, the horrid Samantha, who is also one of Satan's people and not one of God's people, has gone with Wendy Alec as well. But nevertheless, I'm told that new management has been brought in or is coming in, and that there will be the inevitable begathon to raise money because God is not in God TV. Now, for goodness sake, get a grip. There's an old saying, God's work done God's way has never lacked God's supply. If you haven't got the Lord God's supply, something's horribly wrong. Stop. Now, there are times when things are we're just getting by. There are times when we got so much we don't know what to do with us, do with it all. Aren't there? Paul said, I know how to be abound, I know how to be abased. He knew how to have wealth and he knew, but none of those things fazed him at all. Other times he was scraping by just subsistence level stuff. I have had times in my life when I've had a lot of money, and other times in life when I've had nothing. And we all learn that as disciples, and these things don't shake you or faze you in any way, because you know that actually it doesn't matter. As long as you're right with God, does it matter whether you're rich or poor? Of course it doesn't. These are external circumstances and these things are allowed to try you. But God TV is once again going to be launching on a begathon, and we're going to see new management soon. But let's see how they try and pass this off. Are they going to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? The kind of thing that would stand before God, before Jesus Christ, who is the truth? Or are they going to do the ways of the world? Obfuscation, lying, concealing from the body for political reasons. And is politics going to prevail here? Are they going to say, oh, we thank Wendy for all the great work she's done in founding the company, but she's gone on to greater and greater things? No, she hasn't. No, she hasn't. This is just another boardroom battle. The other people got brassed off with her, and the failure of God TV. And there they are. They think they're going to make some money, and you bet Benny Hinn's involved behind the scenes. Benny Hinn's a friend of Wendy Alec, of course. And you can bet that the new management team will have relationships with Benny Hinn. And any of you happen to know what's going on with Benny Hinn and his inner team, I'd like to hear from you too. I will broadcast it. I hate lies and obfuscation. Politics has no place amongst God's people. So Wendy Alec's gone from God TV, not that it affects God's children. They're nothing to do with God, and they're just doing religion, and they're religious broadcasters. Okay, that's how religious broadcasters are. They don't know, they don't understand. They honestly think people like Reinhard Bonnke, Benny Hinn, Manic Morris, Joyce the Goldfish, and umpteen other people are actually something to do with God because they name the name of Jesus. They're no better than a bunch of Anglicans. Absolute, just religious, dry, empty, hopeless people. However, any of you got information, I'd like to hear about this, but you heard it here. Wendy Alec has gone to pursue her career, spit it out, man, of her own egotistical ends, because if she's born again of the Spirit of God, I'm the Queen of China. That ain't no Christian, let me tell you. She's a churchwoman. Now, we're not against Wendy Alec per se, or Wendy Stevens, or Stevenson, whatever her surname is, at all. What for? Well, I am against wickedness, lies, hypocrisy, and downright obfuscation. Let's have openness here. And if you can't function, God TV, in absolute openness and honesty, you know better than a bunch of politicians and the people of the world. You're just like Satan. So, horrors are going on behind the scenes, everybody. As expected amongst the unsaved, because they're not born of the Spirit of God, of course, they're just church people. Never mind. Perhaps we can expose it. How would you like that? Come on, you can help me. Only those of you behind the scenes who know what's going on privately, and I've had various emails from various people who've worked at God TV, including one extremely terse email from somebody who plainly wasn't one of God's people, but I thank him anyway, who was saying what Wendy Alec would have to do to get him to go back there, and it wasn't very pleasant, let's put it that way. They don't have any friends behind the scenes. Okay, this is entirely egotistical, self-serving, self-aggrandizing, self-justifying religion. So Let's hear it, any one of you who happens to know what's going on behind the scenes and who this new management team is, who will want to be wanting to make some money out of this, of course. I'm told that people behind this, by these, my informant, that actually everybody hates them because they won't pay their bills. The reason why the Revival Prayer Centre, so-called, on Union Street in Plymouth, has not been finished on the inside and they're not operating from there is quite simply they haven't paid the builders for the work that was done there. Plymouth City Council had to order God TV and one or two other property owners in the city to tidy up the outside. I'm told it's been painted up. I've not seen it since. I shall have to go to Plymouth again soon and get some pictures for you. But they've tarted up the outside, but the inside is still rubble and a building site. That is typical of church, isn't it? It's all facades and lies, but the reality is just not in them. Okay. So everyone, you got any information? Let's have it. Go to my website, and here's my website, web address again. And use the contact form, anonymous if you want to, that's fine, no problem. And we'll see what's going on, okay.